Audit or evaluation? Politicians, am I right? First, they mandate that you follow a certain program, and then they ask for data to verify the effectiveness of said program. It's almost like they think they're the government or something. This exception refers specifically to the audit or evaluation of a federal or state-supported education program, or to enforce or comply with federal legal requirements related to that program, whether they give you money or not. Then they may have to give some access to student PII if the mandate requires it for the purpose of audit or evaluation. But let me let you in on a little secret. The state or federal government doesn't have to initiate the audit or evaluation. You can do it yourself, so long as it's of a state or federal program. But just a reminder, it's only for the state you live in and for the federal government that you're accountable to. If China calls you up on the phone, you don't have to give them anything. I'll never make that mistake again. Similar to other exceptions with FERPA, there are some requirements for sharing the data correctly. First, the entity receiving the data has to be either a state or local educational authority or the authorized representative of such an authority. Second, a written agreement has to be in place that ensures that the data are only used for the authorized purpose. That means there has to be protections against unauthorized redisclosure. And the receiving entity also has to destroy the data once it is no longer needed for the audit or evaluation. Here's an example for you. Say you're receiving funds from the federal government for running Title I programs. In this case, you may enter into a written agreement with an authorized representative to share the PII with them for the purpose of an audit or evaluation without written parental consent. So remember, if there's no federal or state requirement, then you wouldn't use this exception. Oh, that's so good.